रसिक हो नमस्कार, सहर्ष सादर करीत आहोत ज्ञान साधना गीत। कवी प्राध्यापक प्रवीण दवणे, संगीत विनय राजवाडे।
ज्ञान साधना Good afternoon, everyone. I, Ms. Ghume, welcome you all for the celebration of 40 glorious years of Satish Pradhan Dhyan Sadhana College for its contribution in education, excellence, and modernity. In the view of 40 years, we are presenting you all with 40 unique programs. So here we are with the 34th program by the Department of Business Economics on the topic Analysis of Budget. But first and foremost, I would take this opportunity to invite our principal, Dr. Hemant Chitte sir, who is our backbone and continuous source of inspiration, to give his opening remark. Over to you, sir.
Good morning to all my dear students. A warm welcome to today's guest, C.A. Nikhilesh Toman. I welcome Honorable President Sri Satish Pradhan, Honorable members of the management, my teacher colleague, and all the members of Glorious Poetry team who are taking significant effort to make this Glorious Poetry lecture series popular in the field of education. It is a great pleasure to inform you that our institution is celebrating 40th year of its establishment. It is a prime institution in the field of education. To celebrate 40 years in a unique way, we have designed 40 different programs for our students that will enhance their knowledge, skill, and capability. This is the 34th program organized by the Department of Business Economics on analysis of budget. Budgetary clauses have impact on day-to-day life of the people. Sometimes it is difficult to understand the budget. I am sure this lecture would be useful for students as well as teachers to understand the underlining impact of it. I give my best wishes for this program and also express gratitude to our management to make this platform available in such pandemic time. I wish Business Economic Department and Glorious Poetry team a grand success. Happy learning. Thank you.
For encouraging words. So, for today's session, we will have a keynote speaker with us, C.A. Nikhilesh Toman sir, who is the alumni of our college. He is a C.A. and is practicing since 2001 till September 2015, visiting faculty of various colleges, being an active advisor to his clients since 2011, and monitoring portfolios for his clients. He also conducted various workshops on Dare to Share. Being a popular stock market expert for Jai Maharashtra channel and expert panel for G24, he is also the member of subcommittee of WIRC and presented for various teams. Nikhilesh sir has also written various articles on stock market for various magazines, newspaper, newsletter and web portals. Being speaker on investor psychology investments, awareness and fundamental and technical analysis of various branches of WIRC at various study circles. He has also delivered lectures for Investor Association Kolhapur. Apart from all of this, he loves to play tabla, dolki and have a great passion for cricket. He have also visited Chegaon more than 225 times as a devotee. Now, I would like to call upon C.A. Nikhilesh Toman on this digital platform to share his valuable words with us. So, digital platform is all yours.
Hello, good morning students. I welcome you all in this program. And let me thank first our college principal sir, Deshkar madam, Manjiri madam and entire IT team for arranging this event and also giving me the opportunity to share the knowledge, especially on the concept called Union Budget, Budget 2021. So I'll be very happy to share all those details with you. Let me start my presentation immediately without wasting any further minute. And next 50 to 55 minutes, I'll going to speak on the analysis of budget, what constitutes budget, what is budget, what basically we are having in this budget, how basically we are get benefit, and how to interpret a few terms which are basically very difficult to assess for a layman. So let me go to presentation immediately. If somebody will help me to start, I'll start my presentation. Okay, so our topic is Indian Union Budget 2021, okay, global transition to growth. Let's move ahead. Now this is the basically what we can say our format of moving ahead. What contents basically are there in this PPT? First is a backdrop, the what we can say the scenario before this budget. Okay, then there is an economic survey, snapshot of economy. As you know very well, on 1st of February, we have the budget. On 31st January every year, we have the economic survey also published by the Government of India. So that is a snapshot of economy. Then we'll discuss in detail about the key announcements made in this current budget. After that, I'll definitely go through some tax proposals at glance. And finally, we'll rest the case with the questions and answers of the students. So let's go ahead. Let's move ahead. Now, backdrop. Okay, before this budget, what was the situation? As you know very well, last year we have witnessed unprecedented times, once in a century global pandemic. The pandemic, which is called COVID-19, was really a disaster. And not only our Indian economy, but the entire global economy was in a distress. Okay, they were facing a lot of problems, a lot of economic slowdown. So that was what we can say, that was a pitch to play the next match. Then there was a risk of economy. If you find the global economy was expected to contract by 3.5% in 2020, that was a what we can say the survey of IMF. And the live cost, which basically the 100 million plus people infected with these cases and more than 2 million deaths. Okay, that is also again by the Hopkins University. And the next one we can say, still opportunity to retest the economy through reforms and sectorial focus approach. So dear students, though the condition was very, very difficult, everybody including me, I have faced a lot of trouble, a lot of financial stress during the last year. Still, there were many expectations from the budget itself. And everybody was hoping that the government will come with some reforms, some financial reforms, some economical reforms, by which, again, our shrinked economy may, what we can say, come back to its normal position or normal level. So global economy was expected to grow by 4 to 5% in 2021. That is again IMF survey. Okay, World Bank survey. Second one, a good news that earlier we were talking when the vaccination will done, when the vaccine will come. And now we are with vaccine, COVID shield and all those is now ready. And already it has been started across the country. So optimism on account of vaccine rollouts and the global supply chain realignment. So now slowly and steadily, after so many lockings, or we can say so many lockdowns, lockdown 1 to lockdown 5, now slowly and steadily we are into unlocking situations. So everything is now coming back to their normal positions. Though I know it's coming down very slowly, but still we are optimistic and we are hopeful that in this year, will definitely achieve whatever the targets may be the set by the government of India as well as with the global economy itself. So let's hope for the best. Let's keep our finger crossed. Now, after that backdrop, after that, what we can say, the pitch was available to play the match, okay, to the our finance minister. Economic survey snapshot. What basically the economic survey many of you must have saw, must have read also the economic survey snapshot, the front line of our news on the budgeted day, 1st February, that what basically government is saying, okay, what is their economic survey? So the snapshot of economic survey, I tried my best to put entire things in one slide, though it's very difficult. The pages are maybe more than 300 to 400 pages report, but I have what we can say cut down that to one slide just to give a brief idea what basically economic survey says about. After record contraction of 23.9 in quarter one, a V-shaped recovery in Indian economy with a comparatively modest 7.5% decline in GDP in quarter two. So the first point of the economic survey was, though there was a contraction in the what we can say in earlier first quarter because the entire 3 months we were under lockdown, so there was no what we can say industries were working, nothing, we were completely under lockdown, so there was a contraction in the economy itself. And later on, once we started unlocking few things, unlocking few industries, unlocking few sectors, then we saw a V-shaped recovery also, though it has not been, you can say, excellent, or maybe what we can say, it has not been so much flourishing, but still it was a modest, what we can say, 7.5. And it was modest because though there was a decline in GDP, but everybody was expecting that our GDP may fall to maybe more than 12 or 15%, and our government managed to restrict that fall to only 7.5%. So that is what we can say a good achievement by the government of India last year. GDP expected to contract around 7.7% for financial year 2021. Okay, that was again the, we can say, economic survey says ki still we are in the such a shape that our what we can say GDP may contract. India to emerge as the fastest growing economy as per IMF. Again, see why we are basically taking this reference of IMF. As you know very well, as a student of economics, that International Monetary Fund, okay, World Bank, always everybody in the world are looking at the what we can say the guidance or guidelines given by the IMF. So most of the time we compare our what we can say growth or progress by what, by comparing with those with the IMF guidelines. So basically they have assumed, or they have actually mentioned in their report, that India will be the fastest growing economy in the upcoming year, that is 21-22, with a real GDP expected to grow around 11%. So many of us may think that it may be optimistic expectation from IMF, that last year we were down by 7.5% and this year they are expecting to grow by 11%. So there is a huge, what we can say, gap, like minus 7.5 to 11, means in short we have to grow by almost 18%, then only this figure will come true. But nevertheless, our government is trying hard, they are putting so much of efforts, they are coming with so many reforms, so we are expecting that as per IMF guideline, definitely will grow in the coming years. Headline CPI inflation average at 6.6% from April to December, and it will stood at 4.6% in December 20, driven by the rise in food inflation. See, every time you will find that whenever there is a crunch, whenever there is a situation like pandemic, inflation tends to be high. Okay, the basic problem is what we can say, the always, though there was a circle of what we can say lowering interest rate, but now in this year I am suspecting that we may see some kind of a rise in interest rate also for the first time after many years, and RBI is also trying to what we can say control the inflation. So don't get surprised if we see any rise in interest rates, because last 4 to 5 years we have already saw a huge decline in interest rate to boost the economy, okay, to bring down the inflation. But now we may see little bit of interest rate hike also in the coming year. That is my own expectation, we don't know, I may go wrong, but that's what I am expecting, that RBI may increase little bit the interest rates in the coming quarters. fiscal deficit is also likely to overshoot in the budget estimates. As you know very well, now this fiscal deficit has moved from 3.5% to almost 9% this year. If you have heard the budget, it is now almost nearly 9%. So it's a very big figure. And the problem of what we can say getting deficit is, the deficit is what? Nothing but the income minus expenditure. Okay. Though the earning side, or we can say the income side, is comparatively lesser than our expenses. Expenditure is going on the higher side. So deficit is increasing. No doubt there are many other causes why this deficit is increasing. But this year, definitely there was a shoot up due to pandemic and some other reasons also. So that also a very big, what we can say, you can say a challenge in front of government to restrict the fiscal deficit. Okay, though they are saying that it will be 9%, but it should have been less than 5% in my opinion. But slowly and steadily, they'll again come back to 5%. What is everybody's expecting? Next, India is the only emerging market to be FI inflow positive in 2020. As you know very well, from the day of pandemic, from the day of what we can say lockdown, the only one major area was improving, the only one area where the people were getting money, okay, and that is nothing but the capital markets or a stock market. Though the bank interests were going down, though the prices of real estate were going down, though the gold prices were going down earlier than they stood up, but there was a huge, what we can say, upside everybody saw in the stock markets during the last year. Though there was a pandemic and everybody was surprised how the stock markets are going up and up day by day. On the contrary, there was no, what we can say, supportive evidence on the ground of economical growth. But that was purely the rally itself. I have been a panel expert on various television channels also. So in my every interview, I've spoken about this, that this particular rally during the 2021 we have seen in the last 10 months in the stock market is nothing but purely liquidity driven rally. So the entire world, entire globe is looking at India as an investment perspective, and Indian government is also starving for the foreign investments, and big FI chunk, big FI inflows were there, and hence our stock market is rallied. And after budget also, in the last almost, now we are in the month of March, so you'll find that in the last 1 month also, the stock market has rallied nearly by more than 10% in a very short span of time. No doubt, market liked those, all the, what we can say, announcements made in the union budget, and they give the thumbs up because government tried to boost up the economy in the budget. How, that we will see in our coming slides. But definitely, India is the only emerging market and very large FIS flows are coming day by day. And next one is, startups are faring better. It means the pandemic, a record number of around 12 startups made it into the unicorn list last year. So startups is also what we can say this government is basically giving more emphasis on coming with the new startups, coming with the new ideas, and they are helping those startups with by providing them various subsidies, by providing them various, we can say, taxation revenues or taxation reliefs. And basically the Make in India story is what we can say now is the, what we can, the want of the hour, or we can say the requirement of the hour. So everybody is what now helping the startups also. So now let's come to the key announcements of this budget. Now, already we have saw that basically the economical survey already spoken about what was the, what we can say, government schemes, what the government has done in the last year, what was the result, what the IMF is expecting, and what are the government is also expecting. But now, on the date of budget, we saw various announcements made. So I'll just cover a few of them, because the entire budget, if we start covering, then it may take 3 to 4 hours. But since we have limited time, say 1 hour, I'll focus on more key announcements, which are basically related to our economy, as well as which are helpful to you also to know the which sectors are doing good in the coming days. So, key announcements, budget 21-22, here they are. Number one, faceless user-friendly income tax appellate tribunal to be set up. See, this is the one of the important announcement in this budget as far as income tax is concerned, that now if you want to do any appeal, now faceless, what we can say, appeals will be started. Earlier, we used to appear in front of appellate tribunal, we have to put our cases. But now, during the pandemic also, we saw that all we can see hearings were started online. So this is what basically, now what government said actually, when the appellate tribunal you go and you find what we can say, plead some cases to reduce the what we can say corruption level, okay, they have mentioned that assessment is also now will be faceless. So this government is definitely want to curb on corruption level. And after this government came into power, we saw that the level of corruption is also reduced in our country. So this is very important announcements as far as the income tax assesses are concerned. Next major announcement was FDI in insurance increased from 49% to 74%. That is really a booster for the entire insurance sector. And as you know very well, there are so many companies in the private sector, companies in the insurance sector itself. And there are so many in what we can say job opportunities. And while this FDI is also coming in this industry, I'm sure in more years to come, you'll find that this insurance sector will develop like anything. Because see, in India, we have the largest population, as you know very well, now 130 million plus. And basic thing is what? Basic thing is everybody wants to take insurance nowadays. As you know very well, after pandemic, everybody was starting taking mediclaims also because the expenses are so huge. So ample opportunity or a big opportunity in the insurance sector in years to come. So after your graduation also, one might think of what we can say, looking for a jobs, or there will be many jobs available after a few years in the insurance sector. No doubt, you have to go through some IRD examinations. You have to get those license, and then you can also work in the insurance sector. So this is a starting point for the insurance sector, that FDI is also coming. So more and more companies will see in the coming years, and more people will be buying insurance. LIC IPO in next fiscal. Now, LIC IPO actually was announced in the last budget also, if you remember. But the disinvestment plan was not so successful last year. We are hoping this year it may become what we can say, they will achieve their targets. But the LIC was a previous one. But now it has been clearly mentioned that this year, definitely LIC IPO will come. And being a capital market person, I'll urge everybody to go for this. Definitely you'll get some good amount of returns, because LIC is the largest what we can see insurance company in India. If you see the balance sheet of LIC, the corpus LIC is having is something much more than the total of the all our domestic mutual funds also. So sare domestic mutual funds ek baju aur LIC dusre baju, still LIC is very big. So LIC's IPO is something everybody is keen to watch, or everybody is keen to invest. One person company may be allowed in to be incorporated. This is also something new. Now government is coming with some reforms in corporate sector also, in Companies Act also. Already they have started LLPs a few years back, and now they are allowing you to form a one person company. So which is quite remarkable from the point. See, anybody, like earlier we used to what we can say, there was a difficult formation procedure we have to go through. But now a single person company is also can be identified and can be work. So this is a good move from the government. Decriminalization of LLP Act 2008 on similar lines as in Companies Act 2013. Now basically, if you find that there were a very hard, or we can say hardship from the point of view of directors and members in the companies, in the corporates, but LLPs were basically not covered under those some provisions. But now in this budget, they have announced that now LLP will also become under the proviso, and there will be what we can say actions also can be taken against the LLPs also. See, earlier LLPs were free from all those things, but now LLPs is also come under the similar kind of procedure which is laid out under Companies Act 2013. So this is also a good move by the company to cut down what we can say the malpractices. Sometimes in our country, if you go through some or if you do some malpractices in LLP formation and in the work process, now the all those what we can say unfair practices will be definitely going to be reduced or maybe stop also sometime, and you'll find the fair, we can say, business in LLPs also. Next, to launch a security market code in bid to streamline the security market, the code will be include SEBI Act 92, Depository Act 96, Security Contracts Regulation Act 1956, and a Government Securities Act. So definitely a new code is also coming in the markets, and this code will also what we can say, it will be a comprehensive code which will cover all those acts. And as everybody knows, everybody must have watched the scam series which was based on the Harshad Mehta scam 1992. See, what was that basically? If you find that the Harshad Mehta took the benefits of loopholes at that time in the system, so to curb all those loopholes and to come with a stronger, what we can say, compliance oriented capital market, now government is also what we can say coming with the such type of acts and codes. So in a way, some what we can say malpractices will get stopped, or if anybody do such things, definitely they'll get penalized from the government. So nobody will dare to do the malpractices in capital markets. Next, voluntary vehicle scrapping policy to be announced. So this is also good for the auto sector, and you must have seen that many auto stocks also run up in the last 1 month because they are coming with the policy that after 15 years that vehicle you need to scrap, and then you need to buy another vehicle. So that will definitely going to boost up the auto sector. The demand for what we can say vehicles will get increased, and automatically definitely lot of what we can say jobs opportunities also, because see, whenever any sector get the boost up, all ancillary sectors also will get boost up. So if you talk about the auto sector, then there are so many ancillary what we can say companies which are related to a particular company. Say for example, Maruti is a what everybody knows. Maruti is an Indian company which is manufacturing so many of nowadays models. But behind that particular vehicle, there are so many other maybe hundreds or 200 vendors who are supplying some spare parts and some what we can say loose tools, or we can say to the company. So all those industries will also get boost up. All those industries will also get some good work in the coming years too. And hence, this scrapping policy will definitely help the auto sector in a big way. And so many opportunities will be created in the coming years. And basically, this is first thing. It is meant for what we can say due to pollution. Okay, pollution is also increasing day by day. You saw in Delhi also the high what we can say pollution. So just to curb the pollution also problem, they are coming with this scrapping policy. So environment is also very important. Clean environment is important. Dispute resolution mechanism is revamped in this budget, and ITR filing exemption. What was basically a new for the senior citizen is many actually have got confused that if you are above 75, you need not file a return. No, it is not like this. Listen carefully. ITR filing exemption is only given to those people who are having only pension and interest income. So if any senior citizen is having any other income other than pension and interest, he has to still file a return. Okay, it is not like all 75 years persons are excluded. The only category is excluded is who are only having the interest and pension income. See, 90% of the people are having the same pension plus interest income, or maybe pension nahi hai to interest income. But other than that, maybe 10% of senior citizen must be having some income from house property, maybe some income from business, or maybe some salary as a director, whatever it may be. So those will still need to what we can say file their returns. Only those people are get exempted who are only having the source of income as a इंटरेस्ट एंड पेंशन. ओके, दूसरा कोई सोर्स रहेगा, स्टिल यू नीड टू फाइल अ रिटर्न. एंड द वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट इज आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान. यू मस्ट हैव सॉ दैट मिस्टर मोदी, अवर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर, दे आर ऑलवेज फोकस्ड ऑन व्हाट वी कैन से मेक इन इंडिया, आत्मनिर्भर. दे आर कमिंग विथ सो नाइस आइडियाज दैट दे रियली वॉन्ट टू ग्रो अवर कंट्री. ओके, दे रियली वॉन्ट टू हेल्प अवर कंट्री, दे रियली वॉन्ट टू ग्रो अवर इकोनॉमी. ओके, दे डू नॉट वॉट बेसिकली वॉन्ट दैट वॉट एवर ग्रोथ विल कम, इट शुड बी कम बाय द what we can say with the efforts of our Indian people only, with the Indian soil, on Indian soil. Okay, bahar walon ko jyada entry nahi dena chahiye, though currently they are getting FDIs and getting funds from outside, but funding is a different criteria altogether, but the ownership is still they are keeping with the nation. So basically Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan is what stimulus provided, and the Atmanirbhar is almost 9%. And stimulus by government and RBI combined is 15%. If you see in the pandemic, from the last year, they have announced so many, what we can say, subsidies, so many stimulus packages, and basically meant for the Atmanirbhar Bharat. Okay, so their main intention is to grow our economy. Okay, to help our own people, help our own nation. So basically, government reforms in Atmanirbhar Bharat is what? Increasing in borrowing limits of the state governments. Privatization of public sector enterprise. See, this is one thing. There were so many public sector companies. People were saying ki sab bechne ke liye nikle hai, sab bechne ke liye nikle hai. But we are not going to talk in the terms of politics, because we are students of economics. So we are not see this as a from the point of view of politics. So in politics, you know very well ki when there is a majority of the government, they will always do something good, and the opposition will always try to we can say they are not doing good. Okay, they are doing bad. So let us not go into the conflict of politics, but whatever the government is doing, okay, privatization of public sector, definitely in the longer period of time it will going to help us a lot. Okay, so many job opportunities will be created. See, the what is a major problem in India today is we have unemployment problem. Okay, unemployment is increasing day by day. So to curb that problem, to solve that problem, government is coming with so many measures. So privatize once. See, basically what happens is in the public sector company, the nature of public sector people is something like, okay, aaj haan bhai chal raha hai bhai, haan na bhai, okay na bhai. And once you enter into a private organization, if you will say ki haan na bhai karta hu na bhai, they'll throw you out immediately. Okay, because privatization is what? Nothing but the performance oriented. Okay, they will say ki perform or perish. So definitely once you start in that mindset ki I have to perform, otherwise I'll perish, then definitely growth will come automatically. Okay, ऐसे बैठे बैठे ग्रोथ नहीं आएगी, उसके लिए हार्ड वर्क करना पड़ेगा. यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड फॉर द ग्रोथ. ओके, सो प्राइवेटाइजेशन इन माय ओपिनियन इट इज ऑलवेज वेरी गुड, बट नो डाउट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेल आउट अवर पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनीज. स्टिल द मेजर होल्डिंग विल रिमेन विद द गवर्नमेंट ओनली, बट दे विल डेफिनेटली सी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट मी टेल यू वेरी ऑनेस्टली, इन LIC IPO ऑल्सो एवरीबडी इज सेइंग कि LIC को बेचने को निकाला. जस्ट फॉर योर इन्फॉर्मेशन आई एम सेइंग LIC stake sale is also not more than 3%. LIC's IPO, whatever is coming, is not more than 3% of the total stake. So, agar mera 100 rupay ka capital hai and I am only selling 3 rupees, can you say LIC ko bech rahe? It is not like that. Okay, so my dear students, always try to understand economical concepts and financial matters as a student of commerce. Okay, not see all these from the what we can say from the point of view of your own political party or political agenda. Always see all those things which are coming under what we can say government schemes or maybe government announcements as a commerce student, as a economic students, and just try to analyze whether it will whether it will help our economy or whether it will not. And you will find that in this government, whatever they have announced in last many years, whatever they have done in last many years, it was definitely a great, what we can say, steps, okay, which helped our economy a lot. See, nowadays India is having so much of pride. अभी हमारे बारे में बहुत जगह बोला जाता है, okay? India is a what? India is now a great country. Everybody is talking about India when you go abroad. Earlier, nobody was talking about India, okay? Everybody was talking about the Indian poverty and Indian corruption. But now, in last 5 to 6 years, in last 7-8 years, the scene is changing slowly. Now everybody outside India is talking about the growth in India, okay, the structure in India and the reforms in India. Okay, this government is not, what we can say, afraid of taking harsh decision also for the sake of country, okay, nation first, okay, and not ourselves. So that is the biggest difference. So I will always urge you, I will always request you, okay, always read all these points from the point of view of economic student, okay, or from the point of view of commerce students, and don't let these things in the politics, dirty politics. So next, where we are Atmanirbhar, basically energy sector also. See, energy, you'll find that in Bihar, in Uttar Pradesh, in Madhya Pradesh, I have visited many places. I found that the people there, they are saying ki sahab 10 saal pehle to bijli nahi thi hamare gaon mein, okay. अभी 24 घंटा बिजली है, 10 साल पहले सड़कें नहीं थी, अभी सब जगह सड़कें हैं. सो ऑल दिस व्हाट वी कैन से बेसिक एमिनिटीज नाउ अवेलेबल इन ऑल अक्रॉस द कंट्री. वी आर ऑलवेज कंप्लेनिंग कि मुंबई को कुछ नहीं मिला बजट में, मुंबई को कुछ नहीं मिला. बट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव टू थिंक एज अ नेशन, ओके, एंड इन अवर नेशन देर आर सो मेनी एरियाज विच आर डिप्राइव्ड फ्रॉम दिस ऑल दिस बेसिक नेसेसिटी, एंड गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग नाइस जॉब to providing them, okay. So we should be proud of our government. So energy is one of the sector that earlier we used to see in a few years back in Dombivli also. You must have saw a Friday is an entire day, what we can say, shutdown of lights. In Thane also 10 years back there was a compulsory shutdown for 2 to 3 hours, but now in few years we found that lights are not going, okay. So now we are what we are, energy is what, basically whatever the megahertz or megawatts, now our production is also increasing. Why production is increasing? Because the infrastructure was created by this government. So now the, as per demand, there is a supply also, okay. Earlier there was a short of supply, but now we are in the good health. So liquidity support for discoms, all those power generation companies, government is giving boost, and hence basically they are producing the required energy. Elimination of regulatory assets, basically earlier there was some clause that you need to purchase so and so, you need to purchase so and so. This government is basically saying ki you just purchase whatever you want to utilize, okay. Don't just purchase for the regulatory requirements, okay. Don't waste money in just assets, okay. Try to buy only those assets which are performing, okay. Commercial coal mining also, what we can say, is good. Nowadays huge, what we can say, revenue is collected by the government in the auction of coal minings. Reduction of cross subsidy, so there were reduction also. Earlier there was a cross subsidy, but now the reduction also, because that was a announcement in the budget, as well as this is a policy of the government, if you find. Then agriculture is a very important sector, because in agriculture, what basically India is depend on the agriculture. So agriculture reforms, concessional credit boost to farmers. देखो ये कुछ नहीं था बहुत साल पहले, ओके. ओनली वी नो कि दैट आवर फार्मर्स आर पुअर, इंडिया इज अ पुअर कंट्री, बट नाउ जस्ट लुक एट द फार्मर्स, ओके. जस्ट लुक एट द पीपल हु आर इन दिल्ली, एवरीबॉडी इज हैविंग व्हाट वी कैन से एम्युनिशंस, ओके, एंड व्हीकल्स. सो एवरी नाउअडेज फार्मर्स आर बिकमिंग मोर एंड मोर रिच, बिकॉज फर्स्ट थिंग दे आर नॉट पेइंग द इनकम टैक्स व्हाट बेसिकली यू एंड मी आर पेइंग, एंड गवर्नमेंट इज ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग देम लॉट ऑफ बेनिफिट्स, okay. Always interest what we rate concession, then low cost electricity, some loan waivers, and so on and so forth. So agri infrastructure fund is also created by this government. Emergency working capital for farmers in case of any emergency. Nowadays, earlier farmers were not getting any funds, but now government is providing some funds to farmers, so at least a rural farmer will live happily. Animal husbandry infrastructure also the basic announcement in this budget. Amenities to Essential Commodities Act, and all this basically just to boost the agricultural sector. Then MSMEs are industries. Basically, our jobs main are what? They are coming from the industry and MSMEs. So collateral free loans for business. This is also coming under Atmanirbhar Abhiyan. Funds will be set up for SMEs. PM Garib Kalyan Yojana is also one of them. Subordinate debt to MSMEs. Disallowing global tenders of up to ₹200 crore. See, this is also one of the important announcement. Okay, now up to 200 crores, what we can say. So that means earlier we used to what? Sometimes we used to buy from the outside. Okay. So now government is saying, why from outside? Okay. Let us be Atmanirbhar. Let us start producing whatever you want in our country itself. So save the what? The precious foreign currency also. So now they are helping people and they are looking after that everything, whatever SMEs and industry they require as a raw material. Instead of importing it, let us try and manufacture it. Let us try and build in our country itself. Then changes in the definition of MSMEs also. MSMEs definition is also changing. It is also very encouraging. Then migrant workers, some what we can say rules are also framed. One nation, one card and a free food gain supply to migrants. We saw in the pandemic that there was what we can say Garib Kalyan Yojana, because of which people got food grains for almost 3 to 6 months free of cost from the government. See, these are the things which were basically necessary at that time, because survival was important. And one nation, one card is also good, that any worker, if across India, if we visit from one state to another for, we can say, employment or his job, then definitely he should not get deprived of the things. So that is also basic what we can say good announcement. Though there was a huge what we can say people were opposing that CA and all those bills, but definitely from a longer period of perspective, all these bills are very, very important. Social sector, national digital health blueprint, additional allocation for MGNREGAs. Okay, so government is also continuing with the schemes which are framed by the earlier governments. Technology driven education, PM E Vidya, National Foundation Literacy and Numeric Mission. So nowadays, as we are also what we can say meeting online because of pandemic, otherwise we could have met face to face in college, but still this E Vidya and all this what we can say online is definitely helping us. And because of this online technology, our what we can say studies are also going nicely without any further stoppages. Next, basically healthcare sector, holistic approach, preventive approach is what? Curative and well-being. PM Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat Yojana. This year they have announced this supplementary nutrition program also, and Poshan Abhiyan to be merged. See, basically what was the expenditure? It was almost 64,180 crores over 6 years. Support for health and wellness centers, setting up of integrated public health labs, establishing critical care hospital blocks, strengthening the NCDs. So all this basically coming under what? Because of this pandemic, now government is very, very cautious. So again, if something like this happen, definitely we should be coming out of it very fast. Okay, so more stress is given on the healthcare sector. Then all these vaccines also rolled out over the country. 35,000 crore is provided in the year 21-22 for COVID-19. And you will find that the expenditure on health as a percentage of GDP, this is the first time, okay, this is the first time in 2021, it is 1.8%, highest ever. Okay, iske pehle itna kharcha kabhi kiya nahi tha kisi government ne. So this is the highest. You will find that from 2014-15 onwards, once this government come into power, they have started spending or they are starting expenditure on healthcare. That was 1.2 earlier, and now this is 1.8 of your GDP. So that is a budgeted expenditure for this year. And look at it, health outlays what? Budgeted expenditure was 94,452, and for 21-22. They are expecting huge 2,23,846 crore. So massive what we can say growth possible in the healthcare sector also. So introduction to National Commission for Allied Healthcare Professional Bill is also was a basic announcement. Now let's see बजटेड इनफ्लोज एंड आउटफ्लोज, हाउ द रूपी कम्स इन. ओके, जो मेरा एक रुपया है कम गवर्नमेंट का, मेरा जो देश का एक रुपया है, वो बेसिकली आता कहां से हो, हाउ इट इज कमिंग. सो विल फाइंड दैट इन दैट वन रूपी 36% इज borrowings and other liabilities, 36 paisa is coming from borrowings, then some tax revenue 6%, then you'll find that GST also 15%, corporate taxes are 13%, union excise duty is 8%, then income tax 14%, and non-debt capital receipts, coming from disinvestment and all this, is a 5%. So this way our rupee is coming. This is a, what we can say, a structure where the rupee is coming from. And now it is how going out. Okay, jaise ek rupee aa raha hai to ja kahan raha hai, how it is going out. See, basically how is going out. So centrally supported sponsored schemes 9%, okay, then subsidies 8%, defense 8%. You will find that in this government they have very keen, and almost every year they are increasing their allocation to defense, because you know very well nowadays it is very difficult scenario. Everywhere from China there are sometimes news are coming that they are coming inside our what we can say, they are crossing the LOCs. Sometimes from Pakistan also we are hearing some news. So to cut down all these things, they are increasing what we can say, the expenditure on डिफेंस ऑल्सो. जस्ट इट इज फॉर वॉट, इट इज फॉर सेल्फ प्रोटेक्शन. ओके, ताकि कोई दुश्मन हमारी तरफ आंख उठाकर नहीं देखे. सो दिस गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग केयर ऑफ दैट ऑल्सो. एवरीबडी नोज राफेल वॉज अ बिग 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 एक्सपेंडिचर, एंड नाउ एवरीबडी इज अफ्रेड ऑफ इंडियन आर्टिलरी ऑल्सो. सो नाउ वी आर बिकमिंग स्ट्रांग एंड स्ट्रांग डे बाय डे. देन some interest and payments or what we can say payouts also 20%, because every year we are borrowing something, every year we are repaying something, so that is also going out. Some other expenditure also 10%. Central basically what we can say, social schemes, so many what we can say government is announcing subsidies and all those, it took away 14%. Then finance and other transformers 10%, and 16% is basically they are returning share of their duties, taxation to the state government. So in this way this rupee also goes out. Now just come to the budgeted receipts at glance. You'll find that 19-20, 20-21, this actual and budgeted expenditure and the real expenditure, all revenue receipts are in crores rupees, and now the budgeted what we can say revenue receipts are almost 17,88,424, and the capital receipts basically budgeted is 16,94,812 for 21-22, and for 2021 they are expecting 18,95,152. Actuals were almost 10 lakhs, and budgeted again were 10,21,000 earlier, but now they are expecting more. Budgeted expenditure, again revenue expenditure in crores, you'll find that in 1920 actual expenditure was 23,50,000. In 2021 budgeted was 26 lakhs, and now the real expenditure on 2021 is 30 lakhs. So hence our fiscal deficit is also increasing. Our budgeted expenditure was 26 lakhs and our actual expenditure is 30 lakhs, more than 30 lakhs revenue expenditure, and now they are expecting it to be 29,29,000 crores for 21-22. Out of that, again, separately, capital expenditure is again the same thing. In 1920, actual were 3,35,726. All these figures in crores, no doubt. In 2021, the budgeted were 4,12,000, but actual were real expenditure was 4,39,000. And now in 21-22, they are expecting 5,54,000. See, so much what we can say infrastructure, basically announcements made by the company. So definitely this year, capital expenditure will be more. Budget allocation to major schemes, first is a MNREGA, as everybody knows. Earlier that was 73,000 crores, now it is 1,11,500. National Education Mission, earlier it was just 28,000 crores, now it is 34,000 crores. National Health Mission, so PM Kisan Yojana, everywhere this government is what is increasing the expenditure, and which is good for our nation as well as good for our people. Jal Jeevan Mission also again, government is planning to what? Every village should not be deprived from of drinking water. So they are trying this level, they are hard to what we can say, in our nation, every village, they should have the drinking water. So Jal Jeevan Mission is also there. For that, they are expecting nearly 40,000 crore expenditure. Amrut and Smart Cities, that is what we can say, various projects that now budgeted expenditure is nearly 14,000. Metro projects are also there. This budget, you heard that something is given to Nagpur, something is given to Nashik. Okay, so metros are also coming. So see, because day by day, the traffic will get increased, the highways will get blocked. So they are coming with the metro projects also. And this infrastructure development, see, if you see the infrastructure area, infrastructure development, again, like auto sector or any other sector, you will find that there are so many ancillary things which come in the infrastructure. So hence, when the road construction activity or a metro construction activity, so many other sectors are also get benefited. Job opportunities, okay, then vendors opportunities and business opportunities to multiple vendors. So all this come under this basically project. So government is giving boost. Now, what is budget ministry wise allocation? Now, this is very interesting. Every ministry, how much amount is given or how much expectation. And if anybody want to join a politics, just look at the figures. So accordingly, you can be a minister of that particular. So you'll definitely like to work for a people. Okay, don't get me otherwise. But definitely you'll like to help people. You'll like to work for people. And then only people will say good about you if you work for people. So Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, 54,000 crores. Ministry of Health and Family, 73,000 crores. Ministry of Education, 93,000 crores. Ministry of Railways, 110,000 crores. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, 118,000, a big amount. Hence, I said, okay, so many new roadways will be constructed, new bridges, new dams, all this come under infrastructure. Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, 131,000 crores. Ministry of Rural Development, 133,000. See, means agriculture, rural development, why so much of expenditure? Because this government wants to help rural area people, to help the poor and needy people. Ministry of Home Affairs, 1,60,000 crores. Home Affairs means what? Basically related to defense and all that. Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, 2,56,000 crores. And Ministry of Defense, finally, a huge budget is 4,78,000 crores. So this is a budget of, you can say, ministry-wise allocation. I have just put in the one slide ki how much money will be allocated to these sectors and how much these sectors will perform in the years to come. So just go through key tax proposal before we wind up and go to the question answers. The key tax proposals is tax return filers. See the difference. Earlier there were only 3 crores, now almost more than 6.5 crores. So just I'll go through the brief direct tax proposals. Exemption to already we have discussed for a senior citizen if the income is coming under what we can say interest and pension. Reducing the limit for reopening the income tax assessment. This is the very good what we can say step by the government. So no more harassment to the people from the old we can say records. So now the time is reduced to 3 years. Earlier it was 8 years. Construction of dispute resolution committee for small taxpayers. So now the Achhe Din Aayenge Sach Mein for taxpayers, that any dispute will be definitely going to get resolved very soon. Increase in the limit of tax audit for persons who carry out 95% of the transactions digitally. This is also something very, very big announcement that you just do your entire transactions out, what we can say, digitally, and the limit is now increased to almost 10 crores. So no audit is required. Pre-filing of returns will also cover capital gains from listed securities, dividend payments, eligibility of claiming tax holiday, and startups proposed to be extended. See, this is also very much what we can say important announcement that for startups, they have increased tax holiday period for 1 year. And second thing, see the what we can say, the people who were opted for a direct tax vivad se vishwas scheme. So there was a scheme also announced by the government. You just come ahead with your proposal and definitely pay the taxes. Okay. And we'll close your case and there'll be no, what we can say, harassment. There'll be no penalty and all that. So vivad se vishwas. So instead of disputing, just keep a faith. So that is a scheme is what all about. And keep a faith on government, come ahead, and definitely will support you. So that is a great scheme announced by the government. And everybody, see, look at the number of SSEs. It is increasing day by day. So, and one more, what we can say, important announcement was additional deduction of 1.5 lakh shall be available for loans taken up to 31st March 2022 for the purchase of affordable house. So this is what this will boost the real sector economy. Real estate sector will get boost because more people will come to buy houses because the deduction on what we can say loan is also enhanced. Some indirect taxes, just I'll brief before going into the what we can say question and answers. See, the GST collection is tremendous. And if you'll find why these capital markets are also going up, you'll find that the GST collections are really increasing in last, what we can say, 3-4 months. Now it is more than 1 lakh crore again. Okay. See the graph in front of you. It was 32,000, 62,000, 91,000 from June. And from July, August, September onwards, it rose up to now more than 1 lakh crores. So definitely, economics coming back to normalize. So what are the basic key proposals? Rationalization of custom duty structure for eliminating outdated exemptions. So government is reducing all those, what we can say, eliminating all those exemptions which are actually not applicable. So just they are removing it. Support to MSMEs by recent sharp rise in iron and steel prices and relief to metal recyclers. So definitely there is a rise in the prices. So just to support MSMEs, they are coming with some subsidies. They are coming with some schemes. Rationalization of duties on raw material inputs of man-made textiles. This is again coming under Atmanirbhar Bharat. Rationalization of custom duty on gold and silver. Now that it has been reduced by 2%. Okay, so actually the effect is 2.5%, though it has been reduced by 5%, and then 2.5% cess was levied. So net effect is 2.5%, by which gold and silver may be cheaper than earlier. So that will boost the what we can say. Everybody buy golds and silvers in the, it's an Indian tradition that you may not buy the shares, you may not buy the real estate, but definitely everybody will like to buy the gold and silver. So increasing the duty of solar inventories and interior promote domestic production. So some imports are also what we can say they have made more what we can say costlier to promote the domestic companies. And agriculture infrastructure and development says on small number of items. So that has also been increased. So here I'll rest my presentation. I tried my level best to what we can say, give you the details of this budget. And now over to you for any question and answers. I'll definitely try my level best to answer your questions. I'll be happy to answer your questions. So over to you, sir. Over to you.
Hello, sir. Thank you so much for sharing so much with us. Here, we have few questions lined up by students for you. Let's get into it.
Okay.
Will fiscal deficit of 9.5% increase inflation, sir?
See, in my opinion, definitely inflation will rise in this year, all because the story of pandemic. So here's the fiscal deficit is also got increased to 9.5%, as I said. So there is a fear of increasing in inflation, but definitely RBI will take some steps to cut down that inflation. But definitely I'll feel key in this year we'll see comparatively more inflation than previous year.
Okay, sir. Second question. Is it possible to meet this investment target?
See, very frankly, very honestly, last year's target was also not met, whatever said by our honorary union minister. But this year I'm hoping, because this year the situation is entirely different. We are going, we are coming up from this pandemic, and definitely government will need a huge revenue. Okay, as we saw how the 1 rupee is coming. So definitely whatever disinvestment target they have set, LIC is one of that, and some more Navratan companies will come, and some other companies will also follow from PSU. And I'm hoping that this year government will at least manage to, what we can say, have the 90% kind of, or 80 to 90% kind of target. If they fulfill 100%, if they achieve their target, it will be a great. But again, I'm a little bit skeptical, and I feel that if 80 to 90% is also met, it's a great achievement by the government of India.
Okay, sir. Can stock market boom be related to economic growth?
Yeah, sure, definitely. See, basically what happens is the stock market is a mirror of our economy. Everybody knows that in the modern world, everybody is saying that your economy, how your economy is behaving, how your economy is growing, is calculated on the basis of the, what we can say, the indices of their own countries. So in our country also, our stock market index, that is a Nifty and Sensex, basically, people say if index is going up, that means our economy is going good. So all those what we can say, looking at the parameters, what government is doing is a fantastic job in my opinion. And due to that, we have seen so much of rally also across the indices during last 10 months. And definitely we can correlate that. And I'm hoping in the coming year also, we'll see index also go much, much higher than what it is right now. And definitely our economy will also move a little bit faster than the earlier 1 year we saw.
Absolutely, sir. So fourth question. According to you, what are the positive changes in GST in the current budget?
Basically, the GST itself is a positive whenever it was introduced. And this year, they have come with a few, what we can say, announcement, as we have covered in the indirect taxation. Some GST audit, basically, limit has been raised. Then some procedural matter they have reduced. Earlier, basically a businessman needs to file their returns monthly. Now they are coming with the quarterly type of returns. So they are making this, what we can say, operations more and more smoothly. So basically, I feel that day by day, government is trying to reduce also GST on a few items. Every year, the what we can say list is increasing. And they are also, what we can say, coming with some new reforms in compliance part also. And hence the businessman will also he'll be happy in the coming years because the compliance will get reduced. Though compliance is very, very essential and important, I know, but the compliance should not be such like a businessman will not be, what we can say, able to do their businesses. And now government is also coming, realizing this fact that the compliance part was very, very hectic, and now they are starting, what we can say, reducing the probability of compliance, that instead of filing monthly return, they are asking you to file quarterly. Some places they are asking you to file half yearly. Like, they are coming with so much of reforms in the GST itself. So I think these are all positives in GST itself.
Okay, so last question. Yeah. Is keeping direct tax slabs unchanged advisable?
See, in my opinion, as you know very well, being a commerce student or an economics student, a middle class expectation is always from the budget is to get some benefits in income tax rates. Okay, every year I want to pay less taxes. Every year I want some more and more deductions, more and more exemptions. But when we look at it from a nation perspective, then you will find that if we really want to grow, sometimes we should not ask for, and basically, instead of asking, basically, we have to see from the perspective of government also. See, the fiscal deficit itself is rising to the 9%. So how they will going to give you more and more benefits, I don't know, miss. Because see, if the budget was in surplus, then definitely they would have liked to give us more amenities in way of relaxation of some percentage or relaxation of some, what we can say, tax slabs. But this year they have kept unchanged because there was no room at all in the budget, I feel, that they could have increased. Otherwise, the fiscal deficit might have gone to 10% also. So though it is not advisable from the point of view of the taxpayer, but it is still advisable from the point of view of government. we have to look at it as what we can say as a nation, instead of looking at us from the own perspective.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for sharing your valuable knowledge with us. Here, the question and answer session ends. And now, I would like to call upon Mr. Pancham for giving vote of thanks.
Thank you, Ms. Tiwari, for your wonderful Q&A session. My gratitude on the behalf of Satish Pradhan Nansarna College to keynote speaker, Mr. C.A. Nikhilesh Soman, for helping us understanding the budget in more specific manner. I am sure we will meet again on the real platform when the time permits. We are grateful to the management and principal for their constant support and encouragement. As a student team, we are grateful to the Department of Business Economics and the technical team for all learning we have had. Just a gentle reminder to all, please fill the feedback form to leave your valuable feedback. Have a good day. Stay safe.